Hey beauties, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing the best luxury makeup of 2020. I know you can't see, but I have a little table set up right here with all of the products displayed. Last year, I spent way more money on makeup than I ever have before. And I also received a lot more free makeup and PR than I ever have in years past. So on the one hand, it gave me the opportunity to test a lot of different products. And overall, I would say that 2020 was a pretty great year for makeup. There were so many memorable launches. Of course, a lot of very mediocre makeup as well. But today, we're talking all about the gems. So I pulled out a couple favorites in each category. I have a lot of products to get through, so I'm going to go through each one pretty quickly. I don't think you're going to see a lot of surprises today. In fact, you're probably sick of hearing me talk about some of these pieces, but if anything piques your interest and you want to see an in-depth review, all you have to do is scroll through my old videos from 2020. And I'm going to begin with complexion. I'd say 95% of the products we're going to talk about today launched in 2020. A couple of the pieces I'm not sure about, including this first one, but it's new for me this year. So this is the Farsali Liquid Glass Radiance Make Skin Serum. I love this primer. It kind of took me by surprise, and I had had my eye on this brand for a while because it's pretty popular at Sephora. I always would read through the reviews, and I always thought the packaging and the names were always really interesting, but this year was the first year that I tried any of their products. So this I picked up, I want to say during the spring Sephora sale, and I love it. It's beautiful. It has a little tackiness, it's a little bit sticky in that it grips your foundation, holds everything in place, and you can just feel it, filling in fine lines, pores. It leaves a little bit of radiance to the skin. It does give a slight glass skin effect. If you didn't go on top of it with foundation, you would absolutely look very glowy and dewy. It also has skincare ingredients, it smells really nice. I think this is a clean at Sephora product. 10 out of 10 for me. I don't know when this launched, but I'm so happy I discovered it this year. If I do manage to make it through this bottle, it's something I would absolutely replace. I'm almost 100% positive I picked this up during the spring sale as well. This is the Super Goop Glow Screen with SPF 40. I love this as a primer, but even on days that I might just be outdoors, maybe I'm going to the beach or we're going on a bike ride, something like that where I'm going to be outside and I'm not wearing any foundation, any makeup, this is beautiful. It gives the skin such a pretty sheen. It's a lot more glowy than you might think, but I think it looks really beautiful. It just makes your skin look like you were sent straight from heaven. I love the SPF 40. I find most sunscreens for the face to be really irritating. Either I don't like the smell, they break me out, they make me really shiny, sticky, tacky, I don't like the texture or consistency, or I just don't like the smell. There's something about it that I don't like and I'm not inspired to apply it. Of course, with sunscreen, you're supposed to apply every single day. So I have a very short list of sunscreens for the face that I will wear. I was very happy to add this to that short list this year. Next, I have the LeBlanc Rosy Light Drops from Chanel, and this isn't technically a primer, it's more of a liquid illuminator, so you can mix this into your foundation, apply it on top. You can also mix this into a primer. It's absolutely beautiful, ethereal, bridal, perfect for springtime makeup, winter makeup, and because it is a little brightening, I love to mix this into my concealer as well. That's usually a step I skip on a daily basis, but whenever I'm really putting in the time, if I have a special event, photos, something that I want my makeup to look its absolute best, I will go in with the Rosy Light Drops. I didn't pull them out because I have so many products here to talk about, but if you don't like this pearly pink, I also really love Sunkissed. I also like the Pearly Glow Drops, any of the liquid illuminators from Chanel, they're beautiful. This product is definitely not new in 2020, but I finally picked up this really pretty bronze shade this year. This is the By Terry Sunny Flash Brightening CC Serum, one of my all-time favorite products. I also really love the Rosy Flash. This I picked up, I think, right at the beginning of the summer, and it's so beautiful. It gives you so much glow. It gives you this beautiful bronze lit from within, golden hour, any time of day type of look to your makeup. It is so stunning. You can also mix this into a foundation, but this is best as a primer, especially because it has skincare benefits, so you want to make sure it's close to the skin. Moving on now to foundations, I limited myself to only 5, starting with the new Chanel Le Beige foundation. This replaced the original, but they are totally different formulas, and I actually prefer this new Le Beige because it still gives great coverage, it's still long wearing, but it's more of a natural skin, slightly luminous finish, whereas the original was very matte. I didn't like the shades of the original formula as much either, because I remember when that foundation launched, it was supposed to be this healthy glow summer foundation, and all of the shades had a slightly pink undertone, because it was supposed to make you look like your skin was healthy and vibrant. But not everybody has a pink undertone, not everybody wants their face or their foundation to come off as pink, so I think they did a better job. If you really miss that matte finish, I would go with the Ultra Le Teint foundation. That one is really beautiful. If you like matte, long wear, coverage, this is almost the glowy version of that. It's also the only Chanel foundation that I'm going to talk about today. I was thinking about including the new Sublimage L'Essence Détente foundation. I need to wear it a little bit more. I absolutely love it. Would I consider it to be best of beauty 2020? I'm not quite sure, because of the two Sublimage foundations, I think I prefer the original in the jar. I need to go back and I need to try them head to head. My favorite skincare foundation of 2020 is the new Clé de Peau Radiant Fluid Foundation Matte. I love this foundation, and it kind of took me by surprise. I was intrigued as soon as I found out it was coming out, because this is the matte version of their Radiant Fluid Foundation. The price tag is pretty high because it has skincare, and of course it's Clé de Peau, but it looks beautiful on the skin. Take away the skincare, the price, if you're just judging this foundation based on appearance, it's one of the best. So I would say it's worth it to shell out a few extra bucks, maybe more than a few, to get the anti-aging skincare benefits as well, especially if you're wearing your foundation every single day, if you're really taking your skincare seriously and you want to invest in a good skincare foundation, I highly recommend the Clé de Peau. It's really nice. This next foundation wasn't on my radar at all, but it was sent to me complimentary from Kogen Do through Camera Ready Cosmetics. It's the Kogen Do Moisture Foundation. This was reformulated, so it's technically new this year, but it had been around for a couple decades, I believe, and this is the first time I ever had a chance to try it, and I love it. I think this is perfect as an everyday foundation. It makes your skin look naturally flawless. In my experience, it's best applied with a stippling brush, but anytime I apply this foundation and then I look really close in a mirror, I can't even really see the foundation on my skin. It's so strange because I know I applied it, but I can't see it. It just gives you this natural, perfected, flawless complexion. Really beautiful, also a bit pricey, so I save this for special occasions, but I highly recommend, and you only need such a small amount. Another one of my favorites this year is this new NARS Soft Matte Complete Foundation. This also surprised me because I've never had a great relationship with NARS foundations. I've always wanted to love them. I'll really like the finish, but I could never find a nice shade. Well, one of the great things about this foundation is that it doesn't oxidize at all. So once it dries down on the skin, that's the color it's going to be all day long. So it makes it a little bit easier to find the right shade. I have a couple. I think this is the one I've been using. It's the Sahel Medium 2.5. I love this. If you have very dry skin, you might just need to prime or go in with a really thick moisturizer or just go with a different formula. This might not be right for you if you're dry. I have pretty normal slash combination skin depending on what I'm doing or the time of year. But if you have normal skin, oily skin, this will be great because it truly has a matte finish. It's very perfecting. A little bit goes such a long way. You can cover the entire face and it is full coverage, very full coverage. Great for photo shoots, great for brides. It has no SPF, so no flashback. And then the fifth and final foundation on my best of 2020 list is from Huda Beauty. This is the Faux Filter Skin Finish. I use the shade Toasted Coconut. I love this foundation stick. And I don't generally love stick foundations. I'll use them, I'll go through them, but they're never my favorite. Well, I love this. I've been using this constantly. I know I did a full review, but since then, I've really been going through this foundation. In fact, I'm gonna twist it up as far as it goes. This is all that's left. I've been using this almost every single day. It's great for touch-ups. It's easy to just throw in your purse. It's not a true luxury item. It's maybe high-end makeup, but I highly recommend it. There were a lot of new concealers launched at the beginning of 2020, kind of back-to-back. Hourglass, Pat McGrath Labs, Giorgio Armani came out with a new concealer. I'm probably forgetting a few others. I only have one here, and it is the Pat McGrath Labs. This is my go-to, has become my holy grail concealer. I went through my old Chanel corrector, and I haven't really needed to replace it yet because I want to go through some of my current concealers before I replace that. That would be another favorite, but of all of the 2020 concealers, this is Queen Supreme. I never grab the other concealers when I want my makeup to be perfect. Now, this does have very full coverage. It's kind of a creamy finish, but it's not so creamy that it creases. In fact, I never really have an issue with creasing. It doesn't look dry and crepey by the end of the day, and it gives me the amount of coverage that I'm looking for. So out of all of the new concealers, the Pat McGrath Labs is hands down my favorite. I also like the Hourglass, but it's a little bit too drying on me. Not a problem that I had initially, but now as I've been using it later on, and I might pick it up every once in a while, it always looks a little bit drier than this one. I also really like the new Armani Luminous Silk. It doesn't give quite enough coverage, and the Dior was just a disaster. I have three setting powders here to talk about. The first is this Gucci setting powder. The only place I've been able to find this now, I believe, is Selfridges. I picked mine up directly from the Gucci website, but then they took them away. I don't know if they're coming back. It's a refillable package, so you would think that they would not only bring it back, but you could buy the refill separate. So hopefully this is not something that is exclusive to Selfridges because it's really beautiful. I went with the lightest shade, 01. This is the Matte Natural Beauty Powder. It's very light. Very light, very brightening. But I just think it looks so beautiful. It makes your skin look airbrushed. It has a really nice creamy texture. It's so finely milled. I love setting my under eye with this powder. This is for more of a full face glam type of makeup look because it is so bright. I also really love the new YSL powder. I believe this came out maybe spring, summer. This is the Touche Clot 3D All Over Glow. Man, I am in love with this powder. I love the packaging, but the powder itself is so creamy, dreamy. It's meant to be a universal shade. So if you have darker skin, this might show up as more of a highlight on you. And if you're incredibly fair, if you're very pale, this might be a bronzer topper. I'm not sure how you could really work this into your routine, but if you're somewhere in the middle, if you have a light, medium skin tone, you can use this as a setting powder. I like to use this all over my face. It's not too dark that I can use it underneath the eye. The best thing about this powder is that it's luminous, so it gives your skin the most beautiful finish. It's not too glowy. It's not going to make you look greasy. It just makes your skin look naturally flawless. It's so pretty. The last setting powder I have here to talk about is actually a face palette. This is the Sculpture palette from Hourglass. This is part of their holiday collection this year. It is so beautiful. I love the combination of shades. So it does come with two setting powders, their highlighting powder, the strobe powder, bronzer, two blushes. You can do so much with it. It's great for travel. I know so many people like to collect all of them. It's only the second year I've picked this up, and I prefer this to the Ghost palette last year, which is also really nice, but I've already gotten so much more use out of this one. Moving on now to bronzers, I have four favorite bronzers for 2020. The first one is the Sunset Le Beige Healthy Glow Illuminating Powder from Chanel. This is part of their Summer of Glow collection. It is so beautiful. I've almost hit pan. You can tell because in the center you can barely see that rope design that was embossed on top. It was a nautical collection, so you also have the little nautical logo. This packaging was sadly limited edition, but I think this is identical to the Luminous Le Beige powder. So as soon as I finish this, I can simply replace it with the medium deep or the deep Luminous Le Beige. You get surprisingly great color payoff from this bronzer, and it's not too orange. It's not muddy on the skin, even though it does have a little glow. It's just the perfect finish, the perfect shade. So I love Sunset. I also really liked this cream bronzer from Fenty. This is the Honey Glaze Cheeks Out, shade 04. really nice. As far as cream bronzers are concerned, this is one of my favorites. The finish is beautiful. It's not sticky tacky. It blends perfectly with your foundation. And again, the shade is really perfect. This next bronzer, I was torn about whether or not to include it on the list because packaging wise, 10 out of 10, off the charts. It is by far one of the most beautiful powders launched this year. My only complaint about the Charlotte Tilbury bronzer is that the shade range just isn't very good. There is such a huge jump between each shade, and I don't really think I have the perfect shade. I do have two of them. I picked up the medium and the tan. Yes, this is number 3 tan. This is pretty dark, but the medium is a little bit too light. It just doesn't really show up that much on me, especially if I've sunless tanned. I hope they extend the shade range because you get a ton of product for the price. It's a nice texture. It's a really nice matte bronzer. So I like it. I wish there were more shades, but I went ahead and I included it. I could always mix them together or just be really light-handed with this tan. And of course, when I haven't sunless tanned my body, the medium is perfect. So I can make it work for me. But I just think in general, there are probably some people who struggled to find a good shade for them. Packaging, though, is amazing. The fact that it's refillable is awesome because the refills are going to be even less expensive. My number one favorite bronzer of 2020 is the new Gucci Eclat Soleil bronzer. I picked up shade 3. Also not an incredibly extensive shade range. I want to say there are maybe 6 shades. And I remember hearing they were in sort of a funny order. I lucked out. I picked up shade 3 and it was perfect. But I love the texture. It's so nice. It used to have a really pretty design embossed on top, but I have brushed it away slowly but surely. I'm going through it. It's so creamy. It blends so easily on the skin. I never feel like it looks unblended, and it has great color payoff. It has a slight sheen to it, but it's not too much. I think the Luminous Le Beige from Chanel maybe has a little bit more sheen. This is somewhere in the middle between Luminous Le Beige and a matte powder. We had a lot of bronzers launched this year. I remember at one point it felt like every brand was coming out with a new bronzer. Not a ton of blushes were launched this year, and I feel like I almost went back to basics. I did pick up quite a few blushes, a lot of Chanel blushes, but there were older shades that were always in line. Nothing really special, limited edition. I did pick out a couple blushes that stood out to me, including this Patrick Ta. I have the She's That Girl. This is the Cream Powder Duo. I think these are really nice. I love this shade. I also picked up the Coral, which is really nice. I love both of them. The cream part of the blush has more of a luminous glass skin. It's a little bit more sheer. And then the powder is just really special. It's nice and creamy, pigmented. You can mix the two together, you can layer, you could do one or the other. So I do think these little blush duos are nice to have on hand. I mentioned it earlier, but I also really love the Fenty cream blushes. I picked up shade 02 Petal Poppin'. It's kind of the perfect little poppy pink. These have more pigment than the Patrick Ta cream blushes. This is more of a true cream blush. They're so blendable, so creamy, really easy to work with. They don't break up your foundation underneath. I just found it really perfect. This is kind of an ideal blush shade. Consistency looks really beautiful on the skin. The finish of these Fenty cream products is really nice. The blush that I got the most use out of this year is something that I picked up in spring, but this is just a repackaged version of the original. It's the Rosy Glow blush from Dior, which now it's part of the Backstage collection, so it comes in a smaller compact, which I don't really love. It's pretty, it's cute, but when you open it up, it doesn't have a mirror. So that kind of throws me sometimes when I'm applying this blush. If you're not familiar with Rosy Glow, it looks bright neon pink in the pan, but as soon as you dust it on your cheeks, it's meant to work with your skin, your hydration level, your pH to give you a very natural looking flush. I grab this all the time. This is my go-to everyday blush. I limited myself to only 5 highlighters, which is very difficult to do because highlighters are just beautiful in general. It is hard to create a bad highlighter or a highlighter that isn't really beautiful. My most used highlighter is actually from Dior as well, and this came from the spring collection. It is the Rosy Vibes Dior Skin Nude Luminizer. I love this highlighter. I hit pan and I am slowly but surely going through it. I know I've been asked about this so many times. I've worn this in so many different videos and I forgot to list it down in the description box, and I've had people ask me, what is that pink highlighter? What pink highlighter are you using? It is always the Rosy Vibes from this Dior collection. And even though it is limited edition, it's still available. I believe you can pick this up right now from Bloomingdale's, Dillard's, one of those. You can tell it does give a little bit of a pink sheen to the face. If for whatever reason you didn't want the Rosy Vibes or you couldn't get your hands on it, I also really love this Dior highlighter palette. This comes with four different shades, so you get the gold pearl, pink gold, a rose shimmer, and a golden peach. This is the 004 Rose Gold Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette. I think this is my only highlighter palette. I've avoided products like this in the past because I didn't really see the point in having an entire face palette just filled with highlighter. But now that I own a highlighting palette, I think it is amazing. I really love this Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Superstar Glow Highlighter that comes in the giant Silver Oyster Compact, also refillable. I think it'll probably take me a lifetime to go through this highlighter, but it is so beautiful. It's very creamy, and this was far more impressive than I thought it was going to be. Of course, I said it before, it's really hard to come out with a bad highlighter, but I think I was just highlightered out whenever this launched. I went ahead and purchased anyway because I figured I might as well review it, but it impressed me. There's just something about it. Maybe it's the tone. It just looks really beautiful on the skin. I'm so happy I picked this up. I did think there was a chance I would regret purchasing this. No way. As soon as I applied it the first time, I immediately fell in love. This next highlighter is new packaging. This was the limited edition holiday packaging from Marc Jacobs, but I don't think this is a new shade. I'm not sure when this launched. Could have been before 2020, but this is number 79 Guilty, the Omega Glaze All Over Foil Luminizer from Marc Jacobs. Again, you get a giant pan, so you can apply this all over the face, your cheeks, your nose, your chin. Also the shoulders, the clavicle, neck, chest, décolleté, you can just apply this all over the body. I love the tone. The shade of this highlight is so beautiful. It's this really beautiful peachy rose gold. It looks so nice, especially if you have a tan over the summer. Gives you that bronze goddess, golden hour glow, just naturally flawless looking skin. I have two cream highlighters to talk about. The first is the Pillow Talk Beauty Light Wand. This came out spring of this year with the giant Pillow Talk collection from Charlotte Tilbury. So pretty. I love even the original Beauty Light Wand from Charlotte. This is one of my favorite cream highlights. It makes your skin look flawless. It doesn't emphasize texture. It looks so beautiful. And then I also really like this Rosé Balm Essential from Chanel. This came out as part of the fall collection. That's right. So pretty. It has a very light pink sheen. Makes your skin look healthy, glowing. This is a little bit more natural because it's more of a glossy finish than it is shine, shimmer. That's it for complexion, so now we are moving on to eyes. I have three mascaras that really stood out to me in 2020. First is the mascara that I'm wearing right now. It's the Marc Jacobs At Lashed mascara. I love this wand. I love the formula. It never clumps. It always looks separated, voluminous, length. It does everything. This is just the ideal mascara. So I love this new formula. I also really like the new Gucci mascara. This is the Eve Black Mascara L'Obscure. Really beautiful packaging, great wand. And I think these wands are pretty different. This one is more of a true comb, so it helps separate every single lash. It's really nice, even though in all of the campaigns and the ads, the lashes are really clumpy. Of course, they did that on purpose, I'm sure, just to stir attention. It actually is an incredible mascara. And then the third mascara that I fell in love with is this Wander Beauty, the Mile High Club. Gives you volume, length. This is a tubular mascara, so you can remove it with warm water, which is really nice. Kind of freaks you out the first time you see it. You think you might be losing all of your lashes, but you're not. It's nice not to have to rub and apply soap, even though I always double cleanse and I'll go in with a separate eye makeup remover if I have to. It's so fast and easy to remove, but also the wand is great, the formula is great. gives you everything you could want out of a mascara. Length, volume, separation, does it all. So I really like this one too. For brows, I have three products here, all from Benefit. These were all sent to me complimentary. Well, actually, I think I've gone through my complimentary pencil and I've purchased three additional pencils. So this one I did purchase. The only new product here is the Brow Microfilling Pen. I love this pen. My brow routine completely changed in 2020 thanks to Benefit. So I am a huge fan. They have a customer for life because I was stuck on the Brow Wiz. You know, you get stuck in a routine, you kind of get stuck in a rut and you think that the products you're using are the best and the way you apply the makeup is the best until somebody introduces something new or a new technique and you realize, oh wait, this is so much better than what I was doing before. That's kind of what happened to me with these pencils. They're so much better than the products I was using. So this is the Precisely My Brow Pencil. I have the shade 3.5 here. I recently went through my shade 4. Both of them work perfect. In the Brow Microfilling Pen, I have shade Medium Brown. This is really nice. And then the 24 Hour Brow Setter. This is the best brow gel. I don't know if you guys remember, but at the beginning of the year, in some video, I mentioned that I was in the market for a brow gel. I asked for suggestions. The Benefit 24 Hour Brow Setter is the best brow gel. It holds every single hair in place and they do not budge. So this is amazing. Even though these products are not new, they're new for me. Completely revolutionized my brow game. If I had to choose one single eyeshadow product that stood out to me this year, it would have to be the Loose Pigments from NARS. Not this shade, this is Castaway. I can't find Stricken. That's the shade that I've used constantly in so many videos. I'm wearing Stricken. I know I have it because I applied it, I think, just yesterday or 2 days ago. It's somewhere, it's misplaced for the moment, but I am completely in love with the Stricken Loose Pigment from NARS. I thought I might even go through it before the end of the year. It lasts such a long time, I'll probably have it for a while. It's this really beautiful burnt copper tone. Perfect for applying all over the lid. The shimmer is amazing. I typically wet my brush when I apply it because it is a loose pigment, which I didn't really realize the first time I opened them up. It kind of spilled everywhere. I'm so used to pressed pigments, I didn't realize it could get a little bit messy. I also really like Castaway, Isla Mirada. There are several shades to choose from. They're all really beautiful. But Stricken is my favorite. For eyeshadow palettes, I only pulled out a few because I did a full video on both my large eyeshadow palettes that I picked up in 2020 and my smaller eyeshadow palette. So I will link those videos down below in case you'd like to check them out. I go far more in depth with all of the palettes, but I just pulled out a couple favorites. I have two smaller palettes. This first one is Warm Memories from Chanel. This was part of the spring collection this year. I absolutely love this palette. It is perfect for everyday use. Very wearable, very flattering mauve-y tones. And then you have that little pop of shimmer, the little peach. And then I also really like the Copper Charge palette from Charlotte Tilbury. This is also really perfect, very wearable. There's not a shade in this palette I wouldn't use, which is the beauty of a smaller palette. You know you're gonna use every single shade. So I love Warm Memories and Copper Charge. If I had to choose three larger palettes, I would say the Natasha Denona Glam palette really stood out to me. This is definitely best of 2020. I'm so happy I picked this up. And I almost didn't. I almost skipped it because I typically don't wear a lot of grays or silvers. I lean towards warmer tones, but this is so beautiful. It creates very sophisticated, beautiful eye looks. I also really love this Bobbi Brown High Bar palette. This came out as part of their holiday collection. Completely caught me off guard. I had no idea this was coming, and Bobbi Brown eyeshadows haven't been on my radar for a long time, so I feel very lucky that they sent this to me complimentary. Huge thank you to them because I love this palette. This is ideal for me. It's the ideal size. I don't feel like it's overwhelming. I love the quality of the shadows. You can do daily looks. You can do smoky, more dramatic evening looks with this palette. Kind of has it all. I love that. And then the palette that I've used the most this year will come as no surprise. It is the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk palette. I use this constantly. I keep it in the top drawer. I don't think a day goes by that I don't pull this out for something. I finally hit pan on one of the eyeshadows. That's it. I've only hit pan on one, and I use this almost every day. I use this as a brow shade or an inner corner shade. It looks really beautiful. I almost always use this deeper, kind of chocolatey brown shade. If there's another palette that doesn't have the depth dimension, I pull this out and I use this one. I don't really touch the pinks that much, but I could easily see myself going through every single one of these. One of the best investments makeup-wise I made this year. So beautiful. I could dedicate an entire video to the best lip products of 2020, and if that is something you're interested in, you can let me know. But I pulled out some of my most used lip products and also just my favorites, kind of the best of 2020, starting with these Jimmy Choo lipsticks. Now, unfortunately, these are not some of my most used, even though I should use them more, but I absolutely love them. I love the packaging. I think I purchased these from Harrods. They look like little stiletto heels. The lipstick itself is so nice. The shade is beautiful, but just the packaging, everything about it is so luxurious. Of course, they are pretty expensive. I want to say they're maybe $66 for each of these lipsticks. It feels heavy, it feels incredibly weighted. Just one of the most beautiful splurges. I'm so happy I picked these up. I feel the same way about these Hermes lipsticks. They're so beautiful, the packaging is so luxurious. Every little detail is gorgeous, the shades are amazing. Now these I did get much more use out of, especially this one, this peach. Beige Taladect number 16, and now these are widely available. I remember when they first launched, I want to say they sold out. They were kind of hard to get your hands on. Now you can pick them up at any of the major department stores, or at least the luxury stores. Nordstrom carries them. They're really creamy, beautiful. They're pricey, but they're Hermes. I mean, it's a luxury piece. You know what you're buying when you pick these up. You're not looking for a deal. A couple of my favorite glam lipsticks that I picked up in 2020. Here I have the Hourglass. This is part of their holiday collection, At Dusk and At Dawn. At Dusk is one of my all-time favorite reds now. It is so beautiful, and this packaging is insane. This was my first Hourglass lipstick purchase, but look at this. It looks like a weapon. It's so beautiful. I'm a sucker for unique packaging like this. I am. But not only that, the texture of the lipstick is great. It reminds me a lot of the Tom Ford lipsticks, actually, in that it feels really thick. It just coats the lips and it feels like it's not going anywhere. And then I also really like the Coco Club. This is the Rouge Coco Flash lipstick from Chanel, the red that they came out with. It has a slight sheen to it, so it gives it a unique factor. One of my favorite reds that I picked up for holiday this year. I don't remember when I picked up this lipstick, but I think it is definitely my most used nude lipstick this year. It's Full Fantasy from Pat McGrath Labs. I love the formula. Even though it has a slight sheen, it doesn't feel gritty or glittery on the lips. It's so pretty. Slowly but surely, I'm going through this. I love this nude. I've worn this constantly, as well as this Opal lip gloss from Laura Mercier. This has become maybe my favorite nude lip gloss. It is so beautiful. Anytime I'm wearing a nude lip and I just want to throw a gloss on top, it's almost always this Opal lip gloss. Timeless Beige. This is probably my second most used lipstick of the year. It's just the perfect everyday nude. Keep this in my purse and I use it just about every day, definitely every week. If I'm wearing a nude bullet lipstick, it's the Full Fantasy. If I want something long wear, if I'm going out of the house for some reason, I'm gonna have my mask on, I always use Timeless Beige. And then another one of my favorite lip glosses is the Oil Infused Lip Tint. I really like Laguna. This one is Reef. I'm wearing this one today. And I'm also wearing the Rouge Allure Lac 62 Still. This has become a really nice combination. The Rouge Allure Lacs are still pretty new. I would consider them to be a Best of Chanel, Best of Beauty product. I'm so happy I picked up this shade because this is something I think I'll get a ton of use out of. It's very similar to Timeless Beige though. You don't necessarily need them both. I'm gonna stop there for lipsticks because this video could easily become an hour long. Those are some of my favorites, most used. And then the very last makeup product I have here is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. This is amazing. It is like hairspray, super glue for your makeup. It does leave you looking very shiny. So if you don't like a dewy, luminous finish, this isn't for you. But if you want your makeup to last all day, look hydrated, look flawless, not budge on you, this spray is amazing. It's probably the first time I've really noticed a huge difference with my makeup using a setting spray. I have other setting sprays that I really love because they add instant hydration to the skin. They're a great pick-me-up throughout the day. This one truly holds the makeup in place, and I can tell a huge difference, especially wearing masks, living in Florida where it's so hot and humid. Most of the time, I'm desperately trying to keep my makeup from melting right off. This stuff is awesome. As soon as I go through this, I will absolutely replace it with the full size. That completes my list of luxury beauty favorites from 2020. I know as soon as I stop filming and I put everything away, I'll find 5 or 6 other things that were hidden that I wish I had included in the list. It's nearly impossible to do, but I think I did a pretty decent job hitting all of the bright spots. But thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Leave me your comments, questions down below. I want to hear from you guys. What are your favorite luxury products from 2020? Drop me a comment. We'll keep the conversation going there. As always, I will be linking everything mentioned, everything on my face down below in the description box for your convenience. And for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell.